later. Now we are seeing the, let's see couple of more application of the Bernoulli's equation. Okay, one more application is a spray gun. Have you seen that that spray gun through which you spray some
holy
not holy pichkari, oh, that cockroach wala spray, have you seen? No, not hit with like, see, it is like this. All of you please draw this. Some of you will go out now. I have to act on whatever I say. Otherwise I look like a fool. Every time I say, hey, I show you what you say. Nothing happens. I act on it. So this piston, when it moves forward, what happens? It pushes the gas or air forward. Then the velocity of air will be higher here, much higher, yes or no? Okay, because of that, the pressure here will drop, pressure will decrease. Okay, and this is open to the atmosphere, and here is liquid, this is the liquid which will kill the cockroaches. Here atmospheric pressure is there, alright, and here pressure has dropped. So what will happen is that the air will get sucked in, and with the air some drops of liquid will also go, and it so happens that it comes out as a very very fine drop, so it spreads very nicely. Have you understood the mechanism? Okay, this is a spray gun, a very old spray gun in which you are using that, and nowadays you have, just if you press it like a deodorant, it comes out. Okay, so what happens is that inside that hit, there is already a pressurized gas inside. So when you press it down, what happens is that the hole gets open to the atmosphere. So it gets exposed to the atmospheric pressure as well as pressure inside. So the air rushes outside, and with that it takes some fluid also along with it. So that is what the mechanism is. But earlier there was no such thing as pressurized bottle, so they were using this kind of mechanism to spray the liquid uniformly. You will not take the full liquid and pour it over only one cockroach, right? You want to spread it across, right? So that is why spray gun is there. Okay. All right. Now see, in our syllabus, in your book itself, there are a couple of more examples which explains the Bernoulli's principle. One such example is a heart attack. Okay, now what is heart attack, anyone? What is heart attack? No, she is saying something. You speak only when everybody else speaks. Tell. What is heart attack? No, not a process. What is actually, what it is actually? Blockage of coronary artery may not cause heart attack. I am asking you what it is. Understand, I am asking what is heart attack. Alright, now what happens is that kya bol rahe, what I can't hear it properly. Kaun kutra क्या बोल रहा था? Are you saying something? All right. So heart attack happens. Actually, see what happens is that every organ needs oxygen. Okay. Even heart needs oxygen. And how the heart gets oxygen? From the blood. Blood carries the oxygen and delivers to the every organ. Alright, so if blood is not going in a particular organ, it automatically means that oxygen is not going to that organ. So tissue starts to die. And when tissue starts to die, it will send a signal to the brain and it will cause a pain at that area. The same thing happens when the blood doesn't go to the heart. So lack of oxygen inside the heart, okay, or blockage of oxygen for the heart is the heart attack. Okay, that happens when the blood doesn't go inside the heart. Alright, and when it doesn't go, when the artery is blocked, does it need a complete blockage for heart attack to happen? But heart attack will happen only when the blood is completely blocked. Are you getting it? See, what happens is that even if suppose you have 80% or 30% of blockage, so this is the fat that is stored if you eat a lot of junk food. This is what happens. Alright? Now, hey, this is very serious. You'll get heart attack. What is so funny? I don't understand. Have you ever spoken to anyone who got a heart attack? What kind of sensation? What kind of pain? It is not funny. The kind of pain you can correlate with is like putting 10,000 kgs on your chest. Okay? That is the kind of pain you will have. Okay? And how it starts, initially you'll feel dizziness, you'll feel like vomiting, so you'll go to the washroom. Okay, thinking like, oh, everything will be alright, I go there, vomit and come back to the offline. But if you lock your door and heart attack comes there, gone. So after some time, you'll be like, oh, let me take some fresh air, now it'll be alright. So you come out, and then the complete blockage happens and huge amount of pain will happen. Okay, you can't even imagine. Alright? And then you'll fall flat. And then others will help you, then only something can happen. Your life can be saved, then only. Okay? So immediately you get a blood thinner injection. If you don't get that blood thinner injection within next 1 or 2 hours, okay? The half pant is the red dress. Never. This is uniform. Okay.
School where people used to wear half pant.
Even my dad used to tell me that we had half pant. Like, come on, dad, we had the full pant. No, you. Anyways. So, no, all of you are in the half pant. So they tell you that everyone should wear half pant on Saturday. So, you have to be in half pant for all days. Monday, Wednesday, Saturday, half pant?
No.
You sit here. Take your everything. Sit here. Oh, hey, yo. Stop. Sit there. Sit at that corner. That corner. So, okay, we'll not get into too much of detail. See, what happens is the blood will flow from here with velocity V. Okay? Then it will encounter the blockage. So, velocity of blood here will be less or more? It will be more because A1 V1 should be equal to A2 V2. Blood doesn't know that if I don't go to the heart, heart attack will happen. Blood will flow according to the Bernoulli's principle or continuity equation. So velocity will be higher. So if velocity is higher, pressure will be lower. If you don't want to study, get out. If you don't want to study, get out. You only. I know what is your style. Block your mouth and then speak. As I can be, hey, you can hear. I am very serious. He and me, I am watching you for last 1 hour now. Don't tell me just 1 instant that now I was not talking now. I am telling you for 1 hour only I am seeing you. Don't come to me and tell you my marks are less, why is that? But you are talking. In not listening what I am saying here, you will get less marks. That's sure, I mean, isn't it very obvious? If you don't listen what I say, you will get less marks. It is so obvious. So why are you asking me why I am getting less marks? Isn't it very obvious? If you don't listen what is getting taught, you will not get marks. So easy. So if velocity is more here, pressure will be less. Now if pressure is less, the outside pressure is more. So it will press the nerve. So the area will further decrease or not? Area further decreases. Now velocity will further increase because area has gone down further. Then if pressure further decreases because velocity further increases, the further it gets pressed. So like that is a chain reaction. So even if blockage is 10% only, it can still cause the heart attack. Alright? It is not like the, oh, it is only just 10%, let me eat more junk food, so it is alright. No, that chain reaction can start. Anything can trigger this. Alright? There are people who have 90% of the blockage also, they didn't get blocked, they didn't get heart attack. The doctor tells them that there's a 90% blockage, so they undergo the, what they call? Angioplasty. Okay, and then it was fine. But till that point, they didn't get heart attack. But there are cases in which people who have just 20-30% blockage, they got the heart attack. And the age of 15, 14, 22, 25, it is so common nowadays. Okay? This is one mechanism of getting the heart attack, which is according to what we have learned. There is another mechanism also. Suppose you have artery with this kind of deposition, okay? What happens is that if you sit continuously at a place, you don't participate in any, your lifestyle is sedentary, you don't have any outdoor activity. So what happens if you sit continuously in a place, blood clot can get created on legs. Because of the blood circulation is very less on the legs because of the gravity. Because of that, the blood clot get created in the nerves. They get carried, and then suppose this is a blood clot, it will come and block this. And this is another way people get heart attack. Alright? So don't eat junk food and don't sit for a very, very long period. Okay. It is in your syllabus, so that's why I'm write down dynamic lift. Dynamic lift. What is dynamic lift? It is sort of a mysterious force that gets created because the fluid is moving. For example, have you seen a ball swinging in the air? It swings like that. So in football it is very common. Bend it like Beckham. Right? So Beckham takes क्या वो स्ट्रेट पाथ राइट. सो इट यूजुअली हैपेंस व्हेन पीपल टेक कॉर्नर्स. ओके सो एट टाइम्स पीपल टेक कॉर्नर लाइक दिस लाइक आई एम स्टैंडिंग हियर एंड द गोल इज समवेयर देयर. सो इफ आई किक इट it has to swing and go like that, then only it goes inside the goal. Alright? So, it is as if some force is acting on the ball in this way. Then only ball will move in this way, but you have kicked in this direction. Alright? So, this is called dynamic lift. And another very common example is flight. When it is at the level flight, it is moving forward. There is a gravitational force acting on it. Down. And the engines, when they are on, they are creating the forward thrust. Right? Engines are creating force for it to move forward. Engine is not creating force in vertical direction. A rocket creates vertical force, that is fine. But when it comes to an aircraft, it is a horizontal force only. Okay? So what is balancing the engine? There has to be a force, otherwise it will accelerate downward, it will go down. Right? So that force is the force because of the moving air. Are you getting it? So there has to be some force due to the moving air that is keeping the aircraft afloat or that is creating a swing in a moving ball. Right? That is what is called dynamic lift. Alright? Now when aircraft is moving in the air, it is not that the air is blowing. Air is still only. Air is stationary. But it is an aircraft that is moving. So relative to aircraft, the air is flowing. So it doesn't matter whether air is moving or you are moving. It is just a relative motion of air that matters. For example, if you are in a bike and bike is moving fast, even in a still air, you feel that as if a wind is blowing. Yes or not? Right? Same thing happens with the aircraft. If aircraft is going very fast, with respect to aircraft, I can say that the wind is blowing. Alright, so let us study that what actually happens. Okay. So let's first take the case of ball swinging. Alright. Case number one, ball moving without a spin. If spin is not given to the ball, it goes like this, velocity v. If it goes like this, there is absolutely no force that will act by the air. Because whatever happens above, whatever is the movement of the air above, the air will come like this. Ball is moving forward, right? So air will go like that. So this air's velocity is same as that air's velocity. So pressure over here is same as pressure over there or not? According to Bernoulli's theorem, if I treat this entire ball as if there is no height difference, very small height difference is there, then I can say that P plus half rho V square is constant. Rho gh will get cancelled away, h is same. Okay, so if velocity is same, pressure is same, right? So both sides pressure are same, so it will go straight, no change. Alright, now what if the ball is spinning, then what will happen? Case 2, went down. Ball spinning and it is moving forward. It's, let's say it spins like this and it moves forward with velocity v. Omega is the spin. Okay? Now can you tell me what is the velocity of topmost point? If radius is r, what is the velocity of topmost point? R omega plus v. If suppose v is not there, the topmost point velocity will be omega r, but v is also there, so plus v. Okay, what is the bottommost point velocity? Omega r now this side. So this is v minus omega r. Right? V minus omega r. Now, the upper point, upper portion is moving with higher velocity, lower portion is moving with lower velocity. So the air that is in contact with the upper portion will move with the upper portion. Yes or no? And the air which is in contact with lower portion will move with that velocity. So the velocity of air at the top portion is higher and velocity of air at bottom portion is lower. So pressure over here will be higher than there. Yeah. Yes or no? So now forces will be unbalanced. So there will be a net force acting in this way. So ball will not only move straight, it will start swinging like that. It will become projectile. Are you getting it? Okay, so this is the force because of the pressure difference that gets created. Same kind of force comes in the aircraft as well. Any doubt? This is by the way called Magnus effect. If you don't know. Have you learned this in school?
Yes, sir.
Magnus effect. Okay, is it clear? Now let us see in the aircraft what happens. In the aircraft, have you seen the design of the wing, how it looks like?
Yeah.
The wing looks something like this. This is the view, like, you know, wing is coming out like that. So if you cut the wing, and you look from the front, this is how it will look like. Alright? Now wing has multi-purposes. The design of the wing is such that it generates a force which balances the weight of the aircraft. And also, inside the wing you store the fuel. So you store the fuel. Okay, wing has a huge span area, so rather than having a separate tank to store the fuel of the aircraft, they store it in the wing itself, but that is none of our concern when it comes to studying fluid dynamics here. But still, now if aircraft is moving, how it will move? In this way or it will go like that? That way only, because wing is coming out like this, so aircraft will go like that. Alright, if aircraft is moving like this, how the wind will flow? Wind will flow like this. From the upper side and from the lower side will flow like this. Yes or no? Any doubt? Now in reality, what is happening? The wind is stationary and the aircraft is moving. Right? So this entire, let us say, wing goes from this position to that position, let us say. And this point number one reaches to point number two, and point number 3 reaches to point number 4. Are you getting what I am trying to say? 1 and 3 are actually fixed in the space. It is a wing that is moving. So wing goes like this. So 1 becomes 2, 3 becomes 4. Understood? This entire wing goes forward. 1 becomes 2 and 3 becomes 4. Alright? Now tell me, time taken by 1 to become 2, is it same as time taken by 3 to become 4?
Yes, sir. Yes. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Right? It has to be, because this entire wing has, let us say, taken 2 seconds. Guys, focus here. This entire wing has taken, let us say, 2 seconds to go from here to there. So in 2 seconds, 1 becomes 2 and 3 becomes 4. It is not actually the wind is flowing like that. It is that the wing is going from here to there.
Oh.
Understand that. 1 and 3 are fixed. Are you getting it? But if you see relative to the wind is blowing. Now tell me whose velocity is more, the upper or lower?
Upper.
Upper one velocity is more because it has to travel more distance. So pressure will be more where?
Down.
Down. So this pressure P1 is more than P2. So net force is developed in upward direction. That force is balancing the weight of the aircraft. So force is P1 into area of cross section minus P2 into area of cross section. That is equal to mg. Understood? Any doubt? Is it clear? Copy it down. Now, you might be wondering that just a small ship in the aircraft wing, how it is possible to lift, let us say, millions of kgs of aircraft. So, just to make you believe that it can happen, there is a numerical, there is a very nice numerical in your textbook. I don't know whether you have done that. You have not done it? Okay. Let us take that numerical and see what all things should be there. Okay, so you might be wondering that there should be a huge difference between the velocity of upper and the lower wing. Then only such huge aircraft will be, you know, hanging in the air and going flat. Okay, let us see what kind of velocity difference we are talking about. So here is a question, all of you. Okay, what is the time? Okay, so after this numerical, some of you who don't want to stay back and we'll be discussing the previous homework and few advanced or KVPY level questions. Okay, here is a numerical. All of you, please get it right. Okay, it is important. The mass of fully loaded Boeing aircraft is this roughly. 3.3 into 10 raised to the power 5 kgs. Mass of fully loaded Boeing aircraft. Its total wing area, the total area is 500 meter square. Okay? It is in the level flight with a velocity of 960 kilometer per hour. Okay. You need to find out the pressure difference. Between the upper and lower portion of the aircraft. Find out. Assuming the aircraft is going in a level flight, right? what is height? What? Thickness of? I don't know what you are asking. You have to balance the force, right? Balance the forces. Are you applying Bernoulli's theorem? Don't apply Bernoulli's theorem right now. See, forces should be balanced, right? Vertically it is not moving. So net force should be zero, vertically. Okay. In terms of atmosphere. Tell me what is right.
Suppose the upper
velocity is V1 and the lower one is V2. I am trying to find out V1 minus V2 divided by average velocity, which is V1 plus V2 by 2. Now this average velocity is roughly speed of the aircraft itself. Okay, so basically this is what I want you to find. Alright, now you apply Bernoulli's theorem between a point above and a point below.
Percentage,
but in terms of absolute value, of course, no. 550 को 60 ले गया No, I'll just write down the equation, I'll not put the values.
Function of the flap. Have you seen the flap in the aircraft wing? So before you take
take off, they check the flap. And if they, you have to pay attention. If they, if you see the flaps are not moving before you take off, you have to alert everyone. Okay, because that's a process. They have to check the flaps. Alright? So, what is the function of that? See, the, what happens is, I'll just roughly explain to you, okay? This may not be the exact explanation. So what happens if you open the flap over here, so the air that is flowing will flow like that. You're increasing the path of the, you're increasing the path of the air. So now more velocity is there. So if you open like that, then the pressure difference will be more and you will go up. Are you getting it? But suppose you open it from here, then this path is more now. So you're decreasing the pressure difference. Now it will go down. Are you getting it? Very simple, very crude way I have told you. And on the tail also, there is a flap that moves like this. That will change the direction. If you do it like that, the wind will flow accordingly and you'll get a force in the left side or right side like that. Okay, both the flaps should function. One is to move up and down, other to move is left and right. Okay. Alright, so that is all the theory for this class. We are done with the fluid dynamics. Next class, we will complete the chapter. Okay? And please solve a lot of questions from this chapter. If you have not done for the fluid statics, make sure you do it. It is okay that you are only getting 30-40% of the assignment. Assignment number 1, as you have heard, most of the people found it difficult. But 2 and 3 were very straightforward. So if you get scared from assignment 1 itself, you will never open 2 and 3. Okay? So, even if you are getting 40%, 30%, but you are doing it yourself, that is sufficient. Okay? So those who want to stay back, please stay back.